Mr. Paul Hackett.
Deputy Senators, ladies and gentlemen, things were bad when we spoke to you last October. They've got worse, much worse. There was no reopening date for travel back then. We assumed it would resume Q2 2021. This has now been pushed out to Q1 2022 with no prospect of international travel at all in 2021. The Taoiseach in prime time last Thursday said, and I quote, travel has collapsed, by the way. Travel has totally collapsed. Some of these measures are a deterrent to travel and will have an impact. The CMO on February 1st at the Daily Neffet briefing said, and I quote, it is not realistic to expect people can fly to Europe or other destinations for summer holidays, and the only beach they are likely to travel to is their local one. We now have the €500 fine for anyone travelling for non-essential reasons, so there is clearly no doubt that travel agents cannot trade. We as an industry are responsible and customer-focused. We've always and will continue to follow public health guidelines. However, if NEFID and the government want to close down international travel for a year, they need to put in place the appropriate level of support if they want to have an Irish travel industry when international travel can safely resume. We're a unique sector in that we remain open to clients to facilitate refunds with practically zero income for almost 2 years. The travel sector needs a bespoke response, a specific support as a consequence of being closed on public health grounds to international travel. Let me summarise the supports currently in place. Travel industry is getting the wage subsidy, the EWSS, same as every other sector. EWSS is available when turnover is at least 30% down. We're over 90% down, and for 2021 could be 100% down. We also have no visibility on wage supports after March 31st. Most of the travel industry is getting the COVID restriction support schemes, CRSS. This, as you know, is designed to assist with non-payroll costs. To qualify, a business must be 75% down on turnover compared to 2019, and it applies from level 3 and above. Travel industry has been told it only applies to them at levels 4 and 5. This is an advanced tax credit. It is not a grant. The maximum threshold of 5,000 per week seems reasonable provided your turnover is 4 million per year or less. But for any travel companies above that level, the support simply does not cover non-payroll costs to any material extent. This is a retail-focused assistance and does not cover all Irish licensed travel companies. CRSS doesn't support a downturn in business and is directly linked to the levels in the COVID framework. But clearly, travel agents are prevented from trading, irrespective of the levels, and have been since March 2020. The government introduced a refund credit note scheme in summer 2020. This is a cash flow mechanism to assist with delayed supplier refunds. We need to be clear that the refund credit notes are not a grant, not a subsidy, not a support. It is pure cash flow mechanism introduced with a 9-month delay on the assumption that the industry would be back trading. Clearly, this is not the case, and we need a solution to this issue similar to the approaches adopted with EU approval in Denmark, the Netherlands, Portugal, Bulgaria, and others. This brings us to the issue of airline refunds, or the lack thereof. When we spoke to the committee in October, we outlined the potential reason for the delay on the part of one particular airline being down to a conflict over two EU directives that impact the travel industry. This has turned out to be the case, and we can go into more detail in the Q&A session. The fact is that a significant number of refunds to customers for cancelled flights are outstanding. And given the current talk of no international travel for 2021, we need to discuss the issue of consumer protection and refunds when flights operate contrary to government advice on travel. This is known as ghost flights, and the ultimate loser is the consumer. You may also recall that the ITAA called for pre-departure airport testing when we addressed this committee back in October 2020. The Aviation Recovery Task Force, airports and airlines also called for pre-departure airport testing. What ensued was a debate with the medics over which test should be used, and none was introduced. Subsequently, we're dealing with the issue of variants of COVID that arrived into Ireland in late 2020. Was pre-departure airport testing a missed opportunity? Finally, when we addressed the committee back in October, there was no talk of vaccines. The state is spending €1 billion a week in supports and related costs, and we're being told there is a vaccine supply issue. Well, there doesn't appear to be a vaccine supply issue with some countries, and given this is a life-saving opportunity, it does appear that we are lagging well behind in getting the vaccine into the arms of our citizens. That concludes our submission.